wonderful when all the plants have gone and the air of the planet is clean.
And the great scheme can begin.
Without us wearing nose filters.
Ladra Pundit manages without nose filters.
He's an upper-upper.
But even if the place were fit to live in,
it won't be. Not if the great scheme goes ahead.
Well, there you are. End of message! Have you thought up your official flattery for Ladro Pundit?
I thought I'd just say he's indescribable and incredible. What's yours?
Oh, mine's wonderful. I'm going to compliment him on importing all these sheep and goats to be fitted up as sensory extensions of your computer.
Look out, here we go.
Of their own brain quiz, the computer on went on. Trying to remember her name.
I sympathize. I often do that. But
next look.
My brain was all provoking this small avail to recall the tale.
Treat right time is night time, but
that day could I tell if that day was real or a dream as well?
You tell me, no, you tell me.
And something a familiar ain't not something, but everything
very economical. You could live the same day twice and never notice.
Oh dear! Life's like that. You think you're getting up while you're awake.
That's your mistake.
Life's like that. You wake up in the bed with a shake. Life's like that. And all the pretty fancy dreams make break. Life's like that. Why be upset? Life's like that.
Despite a good deal of dumb insolence, one of them made an affidavit.
What? Indoors?
A Mrs. Marr of no fixed abode.
But she had a fixed name.
Fixed? On being asked several times, she gave her name as Marr. When asked to give a statement, she said, ah. When asked if she had any home address, she said, nah. When asked where she'd been all day, she said, ah. So we charged her under the Drunken Vagrancy Act.
Fine work, Tormandula. Congratulate the girls.
I take it the other 30,000 got away.
One into 30,000 goes approximately. 30,000, which makes a pretty good average. Our police girls are wonderful. Most credit.
You have said it.
Have I?
Yes, you have said it. Give them credit. Credit is only fair. Give them a toss to die or dare, for none of them ask you why or where, for you can witness to their fitness out in the wholesome air and sun. Ah, and when they've made the last arrest and the prisoner has confessed, then with pride we can attest that they're the cleverest force we have, and of course we know about one.
Madam, the current progress report concerns you and your lady police force.
Then shoot the bird of time with the arrow of immediacy.
Last month the figures for progressive action gave satisfaction.
How delightful!
But this month's figures of killing, of violence, of theft and all such forms of self-expression show retrogression.
Delightful! I mean frightful!
Jokes are suspected, for laughter was detected.
Indefensible!
And buyings and sellings and repairing of dwellings.
How sensible! I mean reprehensible!
There was no more burning of books or learning.
Inauspicious!
And just for the looking, there were signs of cooking.
Delicious! I mean pernicious!
Plants and flowers give indication of renewed cultivation.
Pernicious!
A long abandoned place of public sanitation shows evidence of reutilization.
Efficacious! I mean good gracious!
But worst of all, there is writing on the wall.
Writing! Suspicious! How exciting!
Capricious, sir!
fetch the Emperor and escort him to the barge.
But he can't walk anymore, sir.
Then use your intelligence and a wheelbarrow.
It's the lustration of the Emperor. We must go.
Tormentor, will you parade your girls on the riverbank?
As usual. Be careful how you get pushed in.
Only the Emperor enters the water today.
That's a matter of opinion.
Lead on, Prime Minister.
We must go to see the show. The Emperor says goodbye. Friends of all the best, the rich were carried. For the best, and they
chance in the populace on the Acropolis.
What you do?
reached the spaceport, my ship lifted without me.
You were stranded.
I didn't care much, for my credit was such that I easily found a new ship. But we weren't done in space when some pilots gave chase, and we only just gave them a slip.
Pirates, you say?
Yes. Now, who would have expected them in our solar system?
Yours? Enterprising people get everywhere.
Well, we'd gone into subspace to escape, and when we later surfaced back into normal space,
What are you doing in the Emperor's private apartments?
Acting suspiciously.
You are?
Then why ask? I am suspicious.
Suspicious?
Ever since Eclipse Day.
You mean you noticed?
I did indeed.
But how did I give myself away?
You? I meant him.
Him?
The new Emperor.
Did he give himself away?
There was something going on right from the start.
Then you sensed him too. How instantly attractive he is.
Attractive?
Tormandula, have you heard of love at first sight?
As a fiancé of 5 years standing about and waiting, I can think of nothing else. I deeply regret that first sight.
But of course, he's a robot.
No, he isn't. He's a prime minister.
I mean the robot's a robot.
I only hope so.
But it's wrong to fall in love with a robot.
Not wrong. Just plain stupid.
If I should grace a little place in his memory banks, I'd say many thanks.
That would do no good.
If like a friend, he'd condescend to call me sweet, I'd kiss his feet.
Well, he won't touch wood.
If he's got wooden feet, I sure he'll look my way. It's what I pray. I know what I'll say.
You'll be misunderstood.
And if he'd give in and I could win, I'd aim for a start right at his heart.
You're too enthusiastic. His heart's made of plastic.
My girls have searched the Emperor's night quarters.
His night quarters?
They've been through all his drawers.
How ubiquitous.
What do you think they found?
The Emperor?
No, this little capsule.
Is it dangerous?
Not unless you break it. Then it makes a directional blast and annihilates something.
How do you know?
We made these at police school when I was a girl.
But what would a robot want with a capsule?
That's one question. Here's another. Is he a robot?
Well, isn't he?
We shall find out.
How?
I've got the palace rigged up with a special device, a thermometer.
What does that do?
When a robot acts like a human, it sounds an alarm.
What if a human acts like a robot?
It emits a bar of chocolate.
Are you sure it'll work?
Just let him try something.
I hope he will.
I'll be ready for him.
So shall I.
If he should make some small mistake, as people do, then he is through.
He may be too wise.
An H can drop, a glottal stop can give away, and he will pay.
Might be a programmed disguise.
Then you take a look at his eyes. Machines are not, well, you know what, if he tries, it's his lot.
What do you mean, if he tries?
Well, if he so much as tries to touch or cuddle or kiss, he will get this. Whee! Boom! One little bang and we've lost a misguided imposter.
I'll be off to headquarters. I've got to investigate some sickening crimes of rectitude. So baffling when there's no possible motive.
My brigade has made a raid and now they are having fun. Doing their best to grill the prisoners so they confess their filthy business. There's no peace for my police until the investigation's done. Ah!
But worst of all, Mrs. Marr has broken parole.
How?
She's given birth to octuplets.
Goodness!
We're charging her under the Anti-Litter Act.
We're the busiest force we have, of course we know other one.
Goodbye.
Lovely mornings we have on this world, Estelia.
This is an afternoon.
Oh, well, it's a morning to me.
You've been sleeping.
Sleeping to you, recharging activator particles to me.
Your predecessor never slept. He used to sit all night on the roof. He said he was thinking messages to his people.
No wonder he wore out in only 5 years. I was up late myself.
Sending messages?
No, receiving memories.
From the Imperial Memory Banks?
Yes, enthralling. I was able to check up on something.
Indeed.
See that alcove in the wall? Its shape reminded me very strongly of an old ruin I saw on Venus.
Venus? Weren't you made on Extermal?
I went to Venus for a trial run. However, to work.
You were talking of that alcove.
A state business comes first. What news of yesterday's ordinances and decrees?
The introduction of a word voucher system of currency is approved. But Ledra Pundit will be after your blood.
Blood to you, ambient fluid to me. He has been looking at me oddly, not exactly contempt, but not quite respect.
If looks could kill, I'd make my will,
your
my days
would
have a number.
If horns could hurt,
an iron shut would give a safer slumber. If every sort of hostile thought could probe and torture me, I'd grow quite soon a nice cocoon to give immunity.
And if a curse could wound the worst,
I'd not be a succumber.
But since they won't,
why blow me if I don't stay as cool as a cucumber should be?
The government wished to know what the word vouchers will be written on.
Paper.
Where from?
My memory banks say there is a vast store of paper in the temple of a plop-plop.
The temple has been closed for years.
The paper's there.
I was a student priestess there when I was a little girl.
What does that prove? You were a little girl. Now you're a lovely young woman. What a plop-plop is missing.
Instructions awaited.
Reverse your exhaust. Suck, not blow. Ingest and analyze chocolate bar. File a report in the Imperial Memory Banks. Spit out wrapper, if any.
Instructions received.
Next we'll be teaching that thing how to peel bananas. However, as I was about to say,
if looks could kiss, I'd stand like this and look at you a long time. If songs caressed, I'd sing with zest and days of song time. If smiles could scent you round the bent with endless friendliness, I might begin by trying a grin, evincing winsomeness. Then kisses could not be withstood, and hearts would beat a strong time.
But since they don't,
or some have got or won't, there will never be a long time to kiss.
Ah, that's a pundit. No business today. I am declaring it a private imperial holiday.
transport them, nor even if it will work. It does work, however, as you've noticed, and they have thereby escaped the attentions of Tormandula and the Lady Police Force. In fact, they find themselves discharged into the subterranean temple of Aplochloch a few seconds later, having been atomized, transmitted, and reconstituted in the time it takes to think of, say, Jack Robinson. The temple is in darkness. Enormous pillars support the roof. A seemingly unending vista of gigantic masonry stretches into the black distance. In one place stands the great archway of the entry of the teleport machine, like a portion of Stonehenge, but less weathered. In another, we find a palanquin, or small pagoda-like structure, standing athwart the sanctum of sanctums. The flimsy swags and mouldering strings of pilgrims' offerings in this palanquin appear to be agitated by a very localized breeze, very gentle. Nowhere else in the whole temple does anything stir, except for the noise of drips of moisture falling from the cavernous roof. This is the temple of Aplochloch.
Just a chap.
Oh, Aplochloch,
meet them. Has your majesty any special message?
Yes, this. Pray give them my regrets. I'm not there.
Thank you, Ledger Pundit.
Ledger Pundit? That's Caralampo, my old porter.
Porter?
Hush. Caralampo, Caralampo.
I'm Ledro, Ledro.
Caralampo, Caralampo. The special circuit's warming.
Meister, Meister.
Qui spricht
Marsch de Donny?
Kirio Dito,
Servus Acorbo.
What do they say?
It's old Erdwinger. He says he's his master.
Master?
Quod prograffiet?
Credo.
Hote, hote.
Vini formarnos.
He thinks he's human.
Nix esti? Mechanisma. Vostio praima?
Noro.
Que estelta?
Dinner or a war?
Wars are over so quickly nowadays. I shall prefer the
casting about through my mind. I assure you, if you return, you will find nothing for you.
I'll persevere.
Perhaps Stormball has more success on your planet than it ever enjoyed with us here. Their agents lurk on it, and for some time they've been at work on it. I warn you that your race won't be third.
The ancients of Epsomar are already on Earth.
For many years, did you not know?
Poor Earth, my little home, I shall never see it again.
Mine,
yes,
bless you, my children.
What is it, Sergeant Damascus?